About an hour north of Marrakesh is one of the most important mines in the world. Here, a chalky white powder is dug up for the extraction of phosphates. It's a critical mineral that the whole world needs, and Morocco has 70% of its global reserves. So what are phosphates and why do they matter? Phosphates are sedimentary rocks and the natural source of phosphorus. This is essential for the creation of DNA, bone, and teeth formation, but it's also crucial for agriculture. Phosphorus is one of the three nutrients, along with nitrogen and potassium, used in commercial fertilizer. So there's a clear link between the extraction of phosphates and food production. Without phosphates, many farmers might struggle to get good crops.
It's important for cell structure, root growth. I am a small organic fruit and veg grower in Suffolk, East Anglia. This farm is a small-scale agroforestry farm. The whole basis of the farm is to grow more food and habitat at the same time. Phosphates are essential. You think about the macronutrients on plants. Phosphates is one of them.
But what makes them increasingly important is that they cannot be manufactured. We can only use them in their natural form.
So being a mineral, you obviously have to dig it out of the ground and you have a limited amount of it in your soil. It's not a chemical thing, and being an essential nutrient, you can't do without it.
Many are now wondering what happens when the world runs out of this commodity.
The world's reliance on phosphates and their importance are part of the conversations happening here at the IMF World Bank annual meetings in Marrakesh, where delegates have descended to discuss some of the most pressing issues impacting trade, among others.
I spoke with Chakib Jenane from the World Bank about why North Africa plays such a crucial role in phosphate production.
Fertilizers are responsible for about 50% of our global production of food. The soils are exploited every year, leading to less minerals within the soil. So it will be important that we bring more fertilizers, both organic or chemicals, to make sure that we keep the production if we look at also the number of increasing population within Africa.
This chart shows us how the price of three basic forms of fertilizer has fluctuated over time. DAP refers to fertilizers made from phosphates. These reached historic highs in 2022, primarily due to sanctions placed on major producers, Russia and Belarus, after Russia's invasion of Ukraine. However, there were also supply-side issues and trade restrictions with China that pushed up prices. These have started to come down this year, but according to the World Bank, this is not necessarily due to positive developments.
The market is volatile in terms of minerals in general. The biggest issue is that we are coming close to the cropping season and there is high demand. At the same time, recently we have seen an increase in the cost of energy, and this directly impacts on the cost of the fertilizers.
Farmers might choose to use less fertilizer because of higher costs. In turn, this will reduce yields and the quality of crops produced, which then reduces the amount of available food. This, in turn, translates into higher food prices. China, Africa, and the United States are among the biggest importers of phosphorus for their farming sector. Moroccan group OCP is the world's largest phosphate fertilizer company, and it argues that Africa holds the key to global food security.
OCP is a Moroccan company and the global leader in phosphate fertilizers. We are the custodians of 70% of the world phosphate reserves. We are strong believers that Africa has the potential to be part of the solution as far as global food security is concerned. The potential is huge. Africa uses a tenth of the fertilizer use globally. The yields in Africa are a quarter of the global average, and 60% of the world arable lands are in Africa. So really, Africa has the potential not only to ensure its own food security, but to feed the world eventually.
It's not only food security where phosphates are critical. Much of the world is looking to decarbonize by cutting reliance on fossil fuels. As a result, there's growing interest in electric cars, and many of the batteries they use are made with phosphates.
Today, 90% of our phosphate globally goes to fertilizer production. Clearly, the main usage of phosphate today is to serve global food security. Mm-hmm. But we see an increase in use of phosphate for technical usage. And phosphate is considered to be one of the most critical materials for the energy transition. So this share of 10% for technical use will increase over time.
Phosphate is one of the main ingredients in certain lithium-powered batteries, referred to as LFP, or lithium iron phosphate batteries. In 2022, these batteries represented almost 30% of the total market, and demand for them is on the rise. Tesla, for example, has gone from using 20% of LFP batteries in 2021 to 30% in 2022.
The importance of phosphates is undeniable, but their limited supply casts doubt over their future use. And even though these minerals are critical for decarbonization, extracting phosphates also has an impact on the environment.
The mining of phosphate rock can lead to water contamination and air emissions, but potential impacts on the environment can occur throughout the whole process, including during transportation and the drying and granulation phase.
If there was a way of recycling or processing human sewage, that's a place to start, because many of these things end up there. And I'm sure that if it wasn't very expensive, someone would already be doing it. I think it's going to have to come out of necessity, ultimately. At the moment, it's cheaper to open mines. We talk about recycling phosphate. I assume that the reason that that's not happening is because that's even more energy intensive than mining and has an even higher impact on the environment. You know, That's where we're at, really, with a lot of these things, is it's down to what is less energy intensive. There's no silver bullet, I'm afraid. It's complicated.